Hi, welcome to part two or step two of this art journaling video series. This is the second video out of three. In the first video, I introduced art journaling and started with tearing out images for the collage. And so in the second video, we're going to make a collage and then glue it down. And that's the goal for part two. And then the third video is kind of transforming the collage into a piece of personal artistic expression. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna walk you through how I made three different collages. And you can just feel free to work on your own piece throughout. And just like in the last video, there are no rules in art journaling. You're gonna do it your way. And so I'm just gonna show you how I do it. I'll kind of describe what my thought process is. Just so you get a sense of sort of what goes through my mind as I'm putting a collage together, when I decide it's done, that type of thing. But it's just idiosyncratic. It's just how I do it, and you'll find your own way. So let this just be a launching point for you. And then at the end, I'll just show you a little bit of how I glue using the Liquitex gel mat or matte gel that I tend to use when I glue. So we'll talk about materials and that type of thing. So just to start with, you're going to have this pile of images like you made in the last video. And so just start playing with them. And that's how I get started. I usually just start moving pieces around on the page. So grab a piece that catches your eye and just start pairing things. And, you know, when you see a pairing that you think looks cool, you know, just go with it and just keep adding to it, playing with it, and just playing with the images. Here I'm just kind of laying out my images, putting them on the page. And here I have a big full page full of images. And this is a point where I kind of stop and I look at what I've done. And, you know, what I'm thinking with this one is that I really like where I got with the right side. I see a little bit less that I like on the left side, and I just don't feel like they go together. There's a lot of pink on the left side, and on the right side there's the darker images, and I just prefer the right. So I'm also thinking this is too busy. I'm not really sure what it's about yet, so I don't think this is done. This is just kind of getting started with a collage, but I like to show you sort of how I get into it. So now I'm kind of at a stage of rethinking it, but I want to think about what I like about this arrangement. And I'm pretty clear that I like this woman who's facing the light. That catches my eye, and for whatever reason, I think that's cool, so I am going to keep that part and kind of do away with the rest. So let's try it again. This is a blank page, I have this from when I teach the class. Normally I ask people if they have any questions, but you're always welcome to contact me if you have questions by email. In the meantime, I'm just gonna keep going through how I put this collage together. So I added this little series with angels, this darker blue. I knew I wanted some darker images. There's an image of Jerusalem there at the bottom, and then I've got this face and I'm trying that out. And this was when something really clicked. I put the light in front of the mouth and it looked like a cough. And this was in May of 2020 when the pandemic had just started. And so when I put that together, it really resonated with what was going on in all of our lives at that time. So I decided I would go with that. And so here I'm just continuing to lay out my pieces. I've added my woman in front of the now what is a cough. And you know, she looks vulnerable to that cough. So this is starting to have some meaning for me. So So I added these candles kind of beneath her feet, and that was just kind of adding a sense of additional danger. And there's a little bit of balance. There's the yellow candles in the bottom and the angels up at the top left. Tear off that last edge, and that's my collage. So the way that I know that I'm done is that I start to make meaning. And this collage was about fear. You know, it's the start of the pandemic in May 2020, and that's how I felt. It made sense to me. So once I get a collage to a place where I like it and it means something to me, those are my two criteria. That's when I'm done. You know, in some ways you could keep rearranging images forever, but if I get it to a place where I like it and it means something to me, that's when I start gluing. Okay, so this one would be ready to glue, and with that I'm going to kind of walk you through another collage. Okay, so back to the blank page, and this is a very different collage. I started with an image of the ocean, and I liked this potter. So these two images kind of jumped out from my pile, and I really liked it when I combined them and I kind of let the back of the artist align with the rocks. And so that sort of got me started. And I think I was attracted to the ocean because I was thinking a lot about the unconscious at the time. I was getting into writing down my dreams. So I was thinking about the unconscious and the creative process, and that was kind of what I was working with in terms of a theme at this point as I was making this collage. So sometimes when I'm thinking about where to put something on the page, I will put it in a way that will allow my eye to move toward the middle of the page. So the waves are crashing in and I want my eye to follow the waves and see the artist and move toward the center of the page. So I put it there on the upper left. And one thing to note is that, you know, the eye is going to tend to go to the brightest spot on the page, or especially where it's a strong contrast. And so, you know, for example, if I put this yoga black and white, the silhouette of the yoga pose, suddenly my eye goes right to the character doing yoga instead of the artist. So that can be a really great central image if you're trying to draw attention to something, sort of like my vulnerable woman was in the last collage, but it can also be distracting. So in this case, I decided it was distracting. I wanted to choose to focus on the artist, so that's what I did. And I also was playing with some of these other images. I kind of started to think about sort of an underground feel. I found this railroad, this guy who's kind of lighting up the cigarette. This underground is another symbol of the unconscious. And so I was kind of thinking about the ocean, the underground. And I really like to work with connecting lines across images when it happens. And so I saw how the rail line could connect to this line on the rim of the sauna, and guide my eye right from the center of the page down to the corner and back. So that was a neat thing to connect. And you can always just look for opportunities like that. And I like that, you know, I had this guy lighting a cigarette, and then I also saw this person lighting these really neat little lanterns in the snow in this image. And so I brought that together, you know, this idea of the spark of creativity or spark of an idea, illumination. And I decided to try to connect the shaft of light with the lighter, thinking about that. How can I bring connection across the pieces? And I sometimes just include images from my dreams or symbols that I'm thinking about. And I often have wildcats in my dreams, so I brought a lioness into this one. And, you know, the colors also balance nicely. And the placement, the cat is facing inward, so your eyes, again, go toward the center of the page. These are the kind of things I was thinking about as I put this piece together. I added the lichens there below. And then I added some color, this really interesting green. And here I found a piece that really brought some more meaning. There's this carving of a woman holding a baby. And I thought, well, there's another act of creation. And so I've got the artist and I've got the mother. And I thought that that was sort of a nice mirroring of that. And so I'm just playing here. I have a snake at the bottom and an old woman. I'm working with more of those kind of symbols. And sometimes I overdo it. You know, I tried to add a horizon line. I was interested in connecting the line with the ocean of the yellow. But I decided it just got a little too busy in this case. And so I went back to the more simple version that I had come up with. It felt more humble, more earthy, and that was kind of what I was going for. I was trying to feel more grounded, so I went with this version. And for me, this collage was about the unconscious and its relationship to creativity. So for me, that's the criteria. I like it, and it means something to me, so it would be time to paste this one down. All right, I'll do one more, and this is one that I did in a recent class. I started with a pile of torn images, which you can see pictured here, just a big pile of images. And in this case, as I was going through the images, I noticed that a lot of the images I had torn out had circles or spirals just by chance. It wasn't that I was specifically looking for circles or spirals. It was just that once I looked at my pile, I saw so many of the same shape. And so I decided, okay, I'm going to go with that and just explore the spiral. And the spiral for me symbolizes sort of the inner journey, this idea of ever nearing, although never reaching the center. So I just decided I would work with that as a theme. And just so happens, I read Emily Dickinson poems at night before bed, and I had read a poem that week that I was doing this collage that I just thought resonated. It was, "The soul unto itself is an imperial friend, or the most agonizing spy an enemy could send. Secure against its own, no treason it can fear. Itself, its sovereign, of itself, the soul should stand in awe." And this poem for me was just talking about how important it is to be aligned with oneself. You know, if the soul is aligned with itself, it has nothing to fear. At odds with itself, it's just the most agonizing spy. I thought that really resonated. And so I was thinking about that poem. I was thinking about these spiral images. And, you know, I just decided that I would work with a theme, and I summarized it as know thyself. So, you know, in this case, I was working with that idea as I did the collage, processing this idea of the inner journey to better know my own self and to live accordingly. So just to let you know, I don't always have a theme. In the prior collages, it just sort of emerged from the pieces. In this case, you know, it emerged from all the spirals that were in my stack. But I decided to kind of consciously work with that idea, just given what was going on in my life. And I encourage you to just see how that happens for you. You may make meaning as you go. You may just work entirely with shapes and colors and not think about meaning. I'm just describing my process so you get a sense of how I do it. But you'll find your own way. And in this case, I started with this sort of DNA spiral. And I can tell you, I arranged and rearranged these images a lot of different ways. So the collaging can take more or less time, just depending on how long you give it. And this is another part of the process where I really encourage you to not rush. Sometimes I'll put a collage together very quickly, but it's just by chance. And other times it takes me quite a while to really decide I've got it right. So let it unfold and try not to rush or circumvent the process. Just work with it until you really feel like you found your collage. So what I liked was combining these two. I really liked the spiral kind of guiding the eye into this journey of a woman kind of going inward. I thought it was just a really nice piece for my theme. And again, I wanted the eye to move toward the center of the page. So I noticed that the hair was kind of getting in the way, and I thought, well, maybe I'll tear that before I glue it down, which I ended up doing. But I'm just starting with this layout and just gonna keep working with that. And then I had this image of this guy who was kind of draped over his rolling luggage. And, you know, for me, that really just reminded me of the need to prioritize self over stuff. You know, that was just kind of a theme I was thinking about. This the importance of sort of the inner self and not the external material world. So I put that on there. And then for some reason, I just really felt I wanted to include this piece. I worked with that, and I like the idea of this woman as she goes inward, becoming an instinct, this cat that can jump down from the tree, and this young girl, maybe she's an inner child, can catch the cat as it comes down. And I put this piece, which is kind of a just for background, it adds depth and direction. And I liked the color, the red, the sort of felt royal or some type of reference to the heart. And I noticed this piece, especially because I was working with that Emily Dickinson poem. She sometimes speaks about the soul being forged in a fiery furnace, and here was this circle that was aglow. And I thought, well, this is a nice representation of the self, so I'll put that circle in. And I had fun finding other images that just brought out this theme of self and going within. And I thought reflections, you know, catching one's reflection as another relevant theme. So I put this one here on the bottom left. And here's my Daft Punk reference. There's a world within me that I cannot explain. I liked the idea of putting in this image of sort of the creation theme. The spiral again showing up on these little snails, it can be playful. But I thought snails really slow down and they go inward. And the spiral on the shell is protective of that soft inner creature. And, you know, in contrast to the guy that was draping his body over the suitcase, I thought it was a nice reminder again of the priority of things. I added this deep blue, sort of a symbol of the numinous or of deep wisdom. Kind of made me think of a starry sky or constellations, sort of looking upwards, hard to reach but orienting. And then this piece is this woman, she's standing before this red spiral. And I thought, well, is this Emily Dickinson or is this me or both? I'm not sure. But either way, I decided I would place her in sort of a central spot looking at that fiery circle. And then I found this really neat image of a person with a flashlight inside the brain. And I thought, well, that's a great reference to the mind making meaning, searching memories. Telling ourselves how to make sense of the world. Here's another reflection piece that I found. I really liked this girl. Reminded me of my younger self, always a daydreamer. And then my final piece is this kind of ecstatic image of this greeting. There's a female figure meeting another on the other side. It looks sort of like a mirrored, darker, image, and they're hand to hand, face to face. So maybe that's ego meeting deep self, maybe that's consciousness greeting shadow, or however you want to think about this aim of the inner quest, you know, to know thyself. I thought it nicely represented that moment of finding and knowing. So here's this collage that I put together, and I like it and it means something to me, so that would be the time when I would start gluing. So I'll switch to my top-down camera and I'll just do a little gluing demo so you can kind of see how to use the glue. So you'll have a pile of images, just sort of like this. This is the adhesive that I use. This is a liquitex matte gel. It's something that's best used, I think, with a brush. And I have a little water cup here and some paper towel. And that's pretty much what you need for today. So we've got the water, paintbrush, and I've already showed you a bunch of collages. And so just for now, I'm going to clear out these images. And I'm just going to show you a little technique on the gluing and sort of how I do it. And just move all these to the side. So like I said, you can use a journal or you can use something like watercolor paper. That's probably what I'll use for this little demo. But in the prior video I showed you, this is my art journal. So if I were working on a piece, I would just open to the next page. This is the one that I just showed you, the collage, and then I would start afresh, okay? So you can work on your journal, or you can work on a piece that's, you know, just a piece of watercolor paper, or, and I mentioned this in my last video, sometimes people who art journal like to take and repurpose old books. And so this one is one that I did that with. You can see it was actually, it's this book about Muhammad Ali that I found for like a dollar on a bookshelf outside of a bookstore. So what you can do is you can paste pages together and kind of outline them with masking tape. I had someone take a class with me who even painted the pages white just to have a nice clean palette. But that can become the basis for an art journal. And with this one, I had a certain effect going where I wanted to be able to flip it over and have the pieces going this way, facing one direction, and then the pieces going the other way, facing the other direction. So I don't know, it was something I tried. I'm not sure I would do it again, but I just like to show you that you can actually repurpose a book to make an art journal. And that's kind of fun to do. And some people find that to be sort of also keeping with the ethos of collage and reuse. So you can make your art journal, or you can get an art journal, or you can use something like watercolor paper. And so when you're gluing, the way that I glue is I just use my hands and a paintbrush. And I like to just get started with pasting down images. And sometimes I will actually put the paste right on the page like this. And sometimes I'll put it on the piece. You could do it either way. But I'm just gonna kind of put it down. And then the way that I do it, I tend to just use my hands, and I will paste right over the top as I go. And I will just paste. And you know, sometimes when you're working, it can be helpful to have, you know, something like wax paper under your page so that you can just really get messy and not have to worry about cleaning up after. So that's how I paste. I go right over the top and I let it dry. But I have had other people take my class who really wanted to maintain more of the gloss of the images. And so maybe would only paste the back sort of a piece, sort of like I'm doing now, and then paste it down. And I have one woman who showed me that she would use even a roller, sort of like one would use for wood block to roll the paint over. She would go right over just to get the piece to lie flat, and then she would wait until the very end to do any glue over pieces. And so you can do it either way. I've also used an old gift card to kind of flatten images. But the thing is that I actually like the bumps and the different textures. So I think that you can paste just with your fingers. And so I often just kind of finish up and I have my hands all sticky because I've just been gluing. But I kind of like that because there's so few things in professional life where you just really, or at least in my line of work, where you're just really getting to play with glue and and not have to worry about it. So, you know, if I were doing a collage, this is really just a gluing demo, but, you know, I would just kind of keep putting my pieces down, and I would glue them in the order of which I, you know, the reverse order, top to bottom. So, for example, I might have the collage the way I want it, and then lift each piece off, pile them up, and then put them all back on in reverse order. So, you know, you're gluing basically bottom to top. But as you glue, you know, you're just going to be kind of creating your collage, and it's ready whenever you're ready. But I can tell you that even with my best laid plans, when I glue, things always change. And this is only stage two. Once you actually get to stage three, bringing paint, bringing colored pencil and other things, the whole piece is going to change again. So don't get too attached to your collage. It's wonderful. It means something. You like it, but you're still going to transform it. Okay? So that is my just little how to glue demo. I also wanted to show you, you know, if you're traveling, if you're in a hospital waiting room, you know, you can use these little auto mounts. You don't have to glue. You can use things like washi tape, other things if you're not wanting to have all the stickiness and you need to do something a little bit easier to do while out and about. Okay, so I'm gonna switch back to my slides. Okay, and I just want to give you a sense that, you know, this is only step two. The collage can really feel so fun to make and create that it's hard to even think, how am I even gonna make something better than this collage? You know, I love the collage just the way it is. All the images are so neat, and if I paint over them, I might ruin it. You know, I'll have thoughts like that. But I have to tell you, every time, I'm so glad I took the risk and just got started painting, because this is what really makes it your own art journal. This is what makes it your own personal expression, is taking the collage and transforming it with paint, with anything that you want, colored pencil, marker, gel pens. So I'm just going to give you a few snippets so you can kind of see what happens between step two and step three. Okay, so this was a collage that I showed you third on this video. And this is what happened after step three, after painting. So you can see I do a lot of creating of negative space with paint. And some people, especially those who use watercolor more as base, may not have as full of a collage. You might not cover the page with images. Some people will cover a whole page with images and just paint it solid and then layer. I like to put pieces that mean something to me, and then I do create a lot of negative space, and I cover up a lot of those torn edges with paint. So that's one of the things to keep in mind. Here's the second collage that we did. This was the collage about creativity and the unconscious. And here's where I took it in the third step. So really adding to it with paint, also transfer paper I used to trace a root system for a tree, colored pencil. So, you know, you can really have fun with it. And here's the first one we did. This was the one right at the start of the pandemic with the cough and the woman who was facing the cough. You know, the week that I was working on this, there was all in the news about the murder of George Floyd, and so I even brought that theme in, as well as some of the themes of climate change. There was just so much going on in the world at that time, and I put this little rope. I actually used some twine, and so that is something I taped to the back of the page and allowed to come through using a hole punch, and just got myself a little escape hatch over there that I could go to my little safe spot to hide, because that was what I was wanting to do in that moment. So, you know, art journaling can allow us to process things that are happening in the external world as well as the internal world. Here's one that I like to show because it's just fun how I've got this glamour girl in her sunglasses, and I gave her some edge and some attitude. That was how I was feeling, and I had some opportunity to identify values on the other side of the page. That was something I was just thinking about working through. So, you can really make these images into something quite different than they start out as. Okay, so that's the end of step two. So basically you're gonna make your collage and then you're gonna glue it down. And that's what you want to do before you watch the third video. So you're gonna glue the collage down and just let it dry overnight. Maybe for a few days, you can come back to it anytime. So this is usually where I stop. I stop after tearing and then I stop after gluing. And I'll just let it dry, leave it for another day. But when you come back for the third installment of this series, you're gonna want to have your pasted down collage. And you can actually paste more layers. So if you have any more tearings or ephemera that you want to add, any photos that you're thinking of as accents, you can bring those along with the glue or the adhesive. And then you can also think about what art supplies you like to work with. So I'm going to primarily emphasize using paint. I use acrylic paint, but you can use whatever type of paint you want. I've had people in my classes use watercolor. I've had people use pastels and charcoals. Like I said, I've used transferred paper and gel pens. So it's really whatever you like to use. This is one of the places where there being no rules in art journaling and it being multimedia is great. Mixed media, excuse me. And paper towel is always helpful, and a little bit of wax paper, especially if you're using a journal where you're gonna close the pages, it can help as it's drying, but I like to just leave it open as it dries. That's what you're gonna wanna have for the next installment, where we will take our collage and transform it into a piece of personal expression. Okay, thanks for joining.